Hi, it's Mr. Rowe, giving you just a tip on horizontal bandsaw mitre cuts. Quick little trick to make cutting 45 degrees a little bit faster. Bring it. What I have are one of these horizontal bandsaws from Princess Auto slash Harbor Freight, same thing. And I've had it for about 10 years now. And what I like about it, it was fairly inexpensive. It doesn't take up a whole lot of room in the shop because I do all kinds of different things in my shop. So I can't have a big dedicated area for a large bandsaw. But the one thing I didn't like right off the bat is how to cut miters with it. So you have to loosen this bolt and this bolt here. 45 does not stop exactly in the right spot. And so what you have to do, or 90 either for that matter. So when you put it back to 90, you have to put a square on here to line it back up. But if you want to do 45s, you swing that around, it's not in the right spot either. It's just a crappy casting. So I could mess around with the casting, I guess, to do that, but I don't even want to move this. I want to set this up to 90 and leave it there. What I'm going to show you is how to do quick 45 cuts for like angle iron frames or square tube frames, etc. So what I made up was this little jig. Getting jiggy with it. That just drops right in the saw. And this slot right here, it's just under 1 inch wide on this saw. And I think that's pretty standard still on the ones today. But it doesn't matter. Whatever your saw has, you could do this trick. Just, you have to adjust. So I have a 1 inch square bar stock that I have, and I had to shave a little bit off the side.
Square tubing would work too.
Drop in there and be a little bit loose, but you don't want it too loose. Just a little bit of wiggle in there so it'll slide. So this is a 3/8 thick, but I think it's a 2.5. Heavy angle. This is parallel with the backstop, like that, and that helps keep it locked at 45 degrees. So I drilled two holes in the angle and just did a little puddle weld to fasten this on the bottom of the angle. You could drill and tap and bolt it if you didn't want to weld it for whatever reason, but you can't have any welds on the bottom, obviously, because this has to sit in there nice. But if you do bolt it, I would recommend doweling it as well so you don't ever have any movement, because this is never going to move this way and it's always going to be 45 degrees. And this guy here, I always leave this loose because it'll always self-align with the backstop. So whenever I want to do a 45, I just throw the material in there, back to 90, take it out. So I do have a small bandsaw. I realize that if you had a great big heavy bandsaw, you couldn't move it around like I do. Like, I just shove it over. If I want to do like long pieces on 45, I'll just rotate, just kick this over and do a bunch of 45s. Otherwise, you have to have it go way off that way, right? And that's really all it is. So I'll show you a few cuts. DJ play another from the prison is sure highness. Only bad chicks riding my whip. South to the west, to the east, to the north. Bump my hips and watch them go off and go off. But yes, yes, sure. And you don't stop in the winter order. Summertime. I mix it high, getting jiggy with them. Getting jiggy with it. Getting jiggy with it. And what I've thought about doing before, obviously you have your stop here for doing multiple 90 degree cuts. It would be very easy to add, say, a round pipe, weld it on here, and have another rod going off so you have a stop for doing 45 degree cuts. But that's for another video. So, as promised, just the tip.